Welcome back to my channel. Today I am here with a story where something happened to me that a lot of entrepreneurs fear, and that is that someone stole my entire business. That's right, this is not clickbait. Someone actually tried to steal my entire business. And no, it is not a hacker. It is a student of mine, someone that signed up for one of my programs, and she apparently loved it so much, she decided to pretend she was the creator of it, in the sense that she stole all the copy from my website, my sales page, took my videos for my program, and attempted to sell it as her own. Thank goodness I found it, and her website is now down, or at least that part of the website is down. And in this video, I wanted to share with you what happened exactly. So what was the experience? How did I find that this was happening? And what did I do? And some red flags, because when this was happening, when I got the notification that she was copying me and basically copying my entire business, I wasn't entirely surprised. There were actually a few red flags that kind of like were waving there when she signed up and throughout the experience that I was like, huh, there's something feels a little bit funny to me, and I couldn't put a finger on it. And sure enough, when it happened, I was like, ah, that's what it was. Now, in case you don't know me, my name is Kamila Gornia. I am the founder of Heart Behind Hustle and the creator of Aligned Marketing Academy. And that is actually the program that was copied by one of the students. You know, everything that I do, this is why it's so funny that this happened, everything that I teach and everything I do is based on alignment and doing marketing and sales in a way that is congruent with your values, personality, and your vision, right? This is something I talk about a lot. So I'm not into manipulation or feeling icky. It's about actually owning your power, owning your brilliance, being truly yourself, authentically you, and then actually transforming people's lives and making a true impact in the world. Now, I think this is pretty hilarious because the student was copying a program that's about authenticity when clearly she was doing the opposite of that, which I think is kind of funny. Let me go ahead and just take you on a little journey and I'll show you exactly what happened. It was the weekend of my birthday. I just turned 30. Crazy. I can't even believe that. Sounds so weird to say. I just turned 30 on Thursday, and it was a Sunday morning. I decided to go on my website behind the scenes on the WordPress site, and I noticed that I got a pingback. What is a pingback? A pingback is when somebody, some other blog, links back to one of your blog articles. I noticed and I was like, oh, interesting. Oh, this person's blog title for the article's very similar to mine. That's a little odd. So I click on it and I see the entire blog article is actually mine. Now, let me just say this. Sometimes people will actually copy and paste an entire article, but still credit the original author, right? This is kind of like the muddy area. Some people might not be really into that. Some people might get upset and offended, and they would ask the creator of the website to take it down, and that's fine. But at least they're crediting you. At least they're linking back to your site. Now, this person actually copied and pasted my entire blog, and wherever I said my name, she just replaced it with hers. So it was not like, oh, Kamila wrote this, hey, it's great, I'm just deciding to use it as a part of my blog for whatever reason. No, no, no. She actually just literally copied and pasted it and replaced my name with hers, which is obviously kind of the definition of plagiarism. Anyway, so I was like, oh, that's very weird. Kind of not okay, because I remember her name and I remember her, that she's a student, and I'll tell you how the interaction went and how she became a student later. So I was like, huh, okay, well, I wonder if she's doing that to any of my other blogs. And I did see another blog post on there that kind of seemed similar, but this was the only blog post that she posted that was copy and pasted. But then when I was on her actual blog site, another thing I noticed, the full headline was exactly what my headline was, except hers was copy-pasted from my site, and my site had it because I paid a lot of money for a copywriter to write it. Huh, interesting. I decided to go further and looked on her homepage. What did I see? Can you guess? That's right. The exact homepage on my website was exactly her homepage on her website. All the copy was copied, even the headline that was promoting my event. It was just a different button, but it was even that. I was like, really? Clearly, is just very odd. Everything, there was like little columns, everything. There was even a button going to a Facebook group. My Facebook group is called Impact Making Coaches and Entrepreneurs. What did she do? She linked her Facebook group to a group she created called Impact Making Coaches and Entrepreneurs. What the f-? The thing that really, and like, this is where I was like, oh, hell no. I went on the services page. What did I see? Aligned Marketing Accelerator. Does that sound familiar? Yeah, my program name is Aligned Marketing Academy. And you guys can probably already imagine what I saw. And yes, it was the fact that entire sales page was my sales page. Everything, all the copy, not even a word was changed. Everything was the same. Everything was the same. Even the things like, oh, here's my story. Bitch, that's my story. What are you talking about, right? I was just like, oh, hell no. You are not doing this. You are not going to be scamming people and pretending like you're helping them be in alignment with your business when you stole everything I've created, all the time I'm putting into my business. You're doing that. Oh, hell no. Now, the thing that made me feel a little bit better is that the program she purchased hadn't been done yet. It was not finished. So she joined as a founding member into my academy. And the whole premise of joining as a founding member is that you're there and I'm in the process of creating it. So as you're watching this, I'm still in the process of creating it, which is why people are getting to join at a lower rate. And thankfully, I was like, oh, thank God that she didn't get access to the full program. So even if she's selling it, at least she can't actually sell the full program because the full program hasn't been created yet. So I was like, oh my gosh, in case she's like downloading the videos, maybe she's making her own version, whatever it is. Because obviously I didn't buy the program of hers. I didn't sign up for it. So I didn't see what she was actually delivering. She probably wasn't delivering anything, right? If we're being really honest, because that's what a scammer would do. But I was like, oh, well, at least, you know, my program isn't done. So even if she's selling it, you know, she's going to be screwed, right? Thank God. So I saw that. I was like, oh my God. Okay. So the first thing I did, I was like, all right, I have to revoke access immediately. So I went into my Podia, which by the way is a great course creation platform. Check it out. I'm going to create a review, for you guys soon. I revoked her access. And I deleted her from, I removed her from my Facebook group for the Academy. I deleted her from the Instagram account for the Academy. And I believe I blocked her somewhere and I removed her from the my entire newsletter list. So we blocked her on that. And obviously I canceled her payments because she was on a payment plan. And I started typing out an email reply. But she was really fast. Like within like 2 minutes of me revoking her access, she gets an email from Podia saying, hey, your access has been revoked. And she's like, oh, I noticed that my access was revoked. Is there a reason for this?
Are you freaking kidding me?
Yes, there's a reason for it. Not only are you plagiarizing, you're infringing of a trademark, you're basically like stealing my content. I saw your website. You're stealing everything. And I'm contacting my attorneys to deal with it unless you take everything down within 7 days. Now, I was very gracious and I gave her 7 days. My friends are saying I should have been do it within 24 hours. But, you know, I don't know. I guess I just wanted to be reasonable, even though it was a freaking scammer, but whatever. So I gave her 7 days. And, you know, within a couple of minutes, she replied that she's going to take everything down and she hasn't stolen anything to anyone. And that was that. I checked her website. Sure enough, everything was gone. So thankfully, this worked out in my favor and it was pretty easy to get worked out in my favor. But unfortunately, that's not what happens to a lot of people. There were a couple of red flags that I didn't notice were red flags, but there was like a little feeling that I got when she signed up with me, and I want to tell you about them. The Align Marketing Academy, I have been launching through a beta course. So she joined in December 2019. Yeah, she was going through it, I guess. I didn't really know because it was all hosted in a Facebook group. But as soon as I opened the doors, she emailed me. So she said, you know, I actually can't do the payment plan that you offered, but I can give you this much a month. Are you okay with that? And it actually worked out that that was going to be the downsell. So we have a specific downsell that we offer to people once the, you know, as the door is closed, the extended payment plan. So that was actually the extended payment plan. So I just said, you know, yeah, that's fine. You know, we can get you enrolled. And she enrolled in that first day for that. But the first thing that I noticed that was kind of weird is that she didn't engage at all inside of the Facebook group. So the Facebook group and the whole experience with the beta is that you have to engage, you have to like, you know, participate, all that kind of stuff. And that was like the premise. That's why you have to be in it, right? And she did not engage whatsoever. She didn't post, she didn't comment, she didn't like anything, which isn't necessarily that weird, because very often when you do launches, there will be people that purchase that never engage. So that's not necessarily the red flag, but like in the grand scheme of things, combined with everything else, it was a little bit odd, right? So so she signed up, even though she hadn't been engaging, you know, she signed up pretty much immediately. And so then great, you know, we're going along with the beta. She joins the Instagram, she joins the Facebook group, but she doesn't introduce herself. She doesn't say anything. She doesn't engage in the actual paid group either. And again, that's not necessarily that weird, because some people will purchase things and not engage. And that's not necessarily the red flag. That's more like an orange flag. But I did check out her Instagram. So it was actually funny, because I was like, oh, is she real? And it's, I mean, I think she's real. I don't really know if she's real or not, but I did check out her Instagram, and you know, she's very young. It looks like she's 18 years old. She looks like an Instagram model, you know, a very pretty girl, which is why I was like, is she real? Like, I guess, I don't know. I don't know if she's real or not. But that was like, oh, interesting. She's 18, first of all, which is weird, because the ads we were running were for people between ages of 24 and whatever. So I don't know if it was someone that's been following me and someone saw it. Maybe it's someone that is actually in that age bracket and is pretending to be 18. Who knows? Very possible. There's a lot of catfish people out there. So that's a possibility. But anyway, so that was like the first thing, and I was like, kind of weird. She doesn't talk about her business whatsoever. She doesn't seem to have a lot of friends on Facebook. Her Instagram, she does have a lot of followers, or, you know, a decent amount of followers, but she seems to be 18. She doesn't talk about her business whatsoever, not even a single time. So I was like, huh, it's a little odd, but, you know, whatever. Stranger things have happened. I've had all kinds of people purchase my programs, and, you know, who am I to judge? Like, I'm not going to judge, right? You're on your own journey. Who am I to say you can, or, you know, you should do things a certain way? I'm all about alignment, right? So, you know, still there was no engagement whatsoever in a Facebook group. However, in Podia, you can see how much the person is engaging and whether they're watching and consuming the content. And she was very diligently consuming the content, which I thought was great. You know, it's awesome if people are actually like going through each video and stuff like that. But it was a little bit odd to me that there was no engagement whatsoever from her, not showing up for office hours, not showing up for group calls, not showing up and commenting even a single time inside of the Facebook group, which I think if you're actually going through the course and you're actually implementing, you would have questions. Like, that's why it's there, you know? So you would have questions if you were actually going through it, which is why it was a little bit odd. Because even the people that are not engaging a whole lot, like, they at least posted once, maybe, or liked something, you know? So I was like, oh, that's a little weird. She's literally consuming all the content, which later I was like, oh, she was probably opening it up and then downloading as much as she can, maybe with like some plugin or whatever, and downloading the content, which is probably what she was doing. Which is, I'm like, thank goodness I didn't actually complete the program, you know, before I found out. But yeah, so that was the other thing. But then the other thing that was like a huge red flag is that one of her payments declined. Okay. And she said, hey, I need to change the payment information on my card. So she submitted the payment, and that's when I noticed that she was actually paying with gift cards. She wasn't paying with an actual credit card. She was paying with very specific preloaded Visa gift cards, which is, I think, a very big red flag, which also means that this is a gift card and she could just never reload it again once she got all the content. I'm guessing her goal was to get all the content from the course and then just not reload the gift card again, right? Because how am I supposed to, I can't contact the bank, right? I can't do anything with that because the gift card is a gift card, right? It's a preloaded gift card, anyone can buy it. So that was very odd to me. It was very odd to me. And you know, she did pay on time and she paid each time, but it was the gift card thing that really tripped me up. I was like, okay, that is very weird. And she was very fast to change it up. So I don't know, all of it was kind of, there was just like this gut feeling that I had. I was like, I don't know, it's a little odd. Like, I typically look up when somebody purchases, I do often look them up and I kind of see who they are. And typically when people purchase and invest, you know, at the level of the academy, they're pretty excited about it. They're not gonna just kind of like never show up, especially if they're actually watching the videos, you know, because usually people would actually engage but not watch the videos. That's kind of more common than watching videos and never engaging, although I don't know, I haven't really studied it to a deep level. So so a couple things to share with you on protecting yourself just from what I've been doing. It is a good idea for you to ever so often just like copy and paste a bunch of your website to see if anything else shows up on online that people are literally copying and pasting. So there's a couple of sites that you can use for that. To detect plagiarism, so you can check those out as well. Just look up like plagiarism checker, website plagiarism, and things like that. I tried a couple of them with the copy that she replaced. So she actually decided to, she removed all the content that she stole from me, but there's new content on there now. And for anyone that knows copywriting and how long it takes to write copy, I highly doubt that she wrote it herself. And I'm guessing she's scamming someone else now and she's copying their programs, because there's a lot there. And I know how long it takes me to write copy, and it's not, you know, an hour. So I'm pretty sure she's scamming someone else, but I tried to do copy and pasting and plugging it into Google and trying these different plagiarism checkers, but nothing's popping up. So I'm guessing she changed up the words a little bit enough so that it's not triggering those checkers. So, you know, you guys saw the screenshot, so watch out. If it's yours, you know, watch out. Now, another thing that you can do is if someone's doing this to you, you can request their website to be taken down by a specific service. So it's a specific takedown service. You can request, you can Google it. I'm not an attorney, but I don't deal with this that often, but there is a takedown notice that you can send to this takedown host. You can also send out this website URL to Google and tell them that this person is a scammer. They're using your copyrighted material. You can get Google to basically blacklist their website from showing up in any search results, so that they're not going to get any traffic from Google. None of the pages from their site are going to show up on Google. In terms of social media, you can of course also request or report the pages as, you know, this person's pretending to be someone else, or they're stealing intellectual property, and you can report all of those pages. So if someone's pretending to be you, or, you know, anything like that. I mean, I've had all kinds of situations. Even before I had my coaching business, there was someone that was pretending to be me because I was a nightlife photographer back in the day. And I guess I knew a good amount of people in Chicago nightlife scene, and there were two or three different occasions where someone was pretending to be me on Twitter. It was a little weird. They were using like my photos, my name. It was probably like a crazy ex-boyfriend, I'm guessing. Like, who else would really want to, I don't know. Anyways. And then the other thing, which is why we're going to talk to the attorney, is to make sure that you have, you know, when somebody's purchasing your products, make sure that you have clear terms and conditions. It's very also clear on your website with, you know, terms of use that you are not allowed to copy, you are not allowed to resell. I have that very clear on my site. So everything is protected, thankfully. And, you know, we have the rights to the stuff that's being posted on the website. And, you know, make sure if something like this happens, you have someone to reach out to. So you have an attorney to reach out to in case something like this happens, so that they can actually, you know, send a cease and desist, or they can do whatever other lawyerly things to help protect you, because that is their job, right? I'm just glad this didn't have to happen this time. You know, and just be aware, keep your eyes open, be aware of what's going on. Something I definitely recommend is that if you're using a brand name, a company name, definitely try to trademark it, you know, or maybe you have a very specific program name or a methodology you've developed, get it trademarked. Because if it's not trademarked officially, you know, with the actual federal trademark office, US Patent and Trademark Office, or whatever it's called, you know, it's kind of like, all right, well, you don't really have that many rights. So, for example, this is why I made sure to trademark Heart Behind Hustle, because I knew that the combination of heart and hustle is used pretty often, right? So I wanted to make sure I'm the only one that gets to use the combination of heart and hustle when it comes to entrepreneurial services. So if you like this video and you want to see more entrepreneurship related videos, marketing, business, and lifestyle, make sure that you hit that subscribe button and that notification bell so you can see more videos I'll be releasing this year. Thank you so much for watching, and I appreciate you, and I'm sending you all the good vibes to stay happy and non-copied by people. Thanks for watching.